The battle is over, and the brave warriors are returning victorious from the battlefield. The army leader, Don Pedro, Prince of Aragon, along with a few of his captains, Lord Claudio, Lord Benedict, Don John, and his servant Borgia, are riding towards a marvelous castle. The sensational castle belongs to Leonato, the governor of Messina, who is organizing a grand masquerade ball at his castle in the honor of the brave warriors. Benedict is loud, funny, and brags a lot. Claudio is quiet, shy, and a new war hero. Don John, Don Pedro's half-brother, is the malicious villain of the play. He is jealous of Claudio for being the hero of the war. The man riding the donkey is the evil Borgia, Don John's servant.
Hero is Leonato's daughter. She's in love with Claudio, the brave soldier. Hero and Claudio like each other very much, but Claudio is too scared to tell Hero, so he asks Don Pedro to talk to Hero and Leonato if they're okay with them getting married.
Hero is the most wonderful person in the world. Now that I've seen her beauty, I can't live without her. If I don't marry her, I'll never be happy again.
Hero and Claudio decide that it would make them happier if Benedict and Beatrice, Hero's cousin, were to fall in love. This is quite a challenge because Benedict and Beatrice are always mean to each other. Listen to Beatrice talking to Benedict at the masquerade ball, pretending she does not know who was hiding beneath the other person's mask, although she actually knew it was Benedict.
Benedict is the most irritating man I've ever met, because he thinks he's as witty as me. If he lived off his wit, he would die of starvation. He's the prince's jester and the dullest of fools. People laugh more behind his back than they laugh at his jokes.
Claudia and Hera decide to trick them into loving one another by spreading rumors about them being in love. All the men spread rumors about Beatrice.
What a couple Benedict and Beatrice would make. I suspect that they are fonder of each other than they realize.
Allora, Leonato! So, your niece Beatrice loves Benedict?
To distraction, my lord. It's pitiful to hear her at night whispering his name and weeping. She knows that if Benedict finds out that she loves him, he will mock her for it. To avoid the humiliation, she keeps her breaking heart hidden.
Beatrice loves me. Poor girl, I can't stand by and watch her suffer. She must be rescued, and the only rescue is for me to woo her.
All the women help spread rumors about Benedict.
Lord Benedict, in love with Beatrice?
Don Pedro told me so. He asked me to mention it to Beatrice, but I refused. She'll never return Benedict's love. Beatrice is too cold and proud to surrender herself to any man. If she knew about Benedict, she would make a laughing stock of him, no matter how sick with love he is. Better for the poor man to die from love than from the lashing of Lady Beatrice's tongue.
Cold, proud, me? I'll show them how wrong they are. I'll save Benedict's life by loving him. Don't die, dearest Benedict.
So the plan works, and Benedict and Beatrice fall in love. Don John tries to ruin Claudia's love by playing a dirty trick on him. He takes Claudia for a walk and shows him a man talking romantically to a woman at Hero's window. Thinks this woman is Hera, but he is wrong. The woman is actually Hera's servant, fulfilling Don John's evil plan. But Claudia's heart is broken. Next scene happens the following day on the morning of the wedding at the family chapel. I tried to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. When the priest asks if anyone knows a reason why the two should not get married, Claudia says,
I know a reason. She is dishonorable. Last night I saw her embracing another man.
Hero is heartbroken and falls on the floor. Claudia thinks she's dead, but she's not. She has just fainted.
Claudia doesn't deserve her. He should be punished. If I were a man, I would make Claudia suffer for what he has done. Go to Claudia, tell him that he is dead, and challenge him to a duel.
Renato knew that his daughter was not dead and decided to teach Claudia a lesson. In the meantime, a policeman arrests Borachia, Don John's servant, who confessed that, in fact, it was him that deceived Claudia.
The woman you saw me with last night was Lady Margaret, Lady Eros Chambermid, dressed in some of her mistress's old clothes. Don John paid me to do it.
Hero was innocent, and I killed her. How can I gain your forgiveness?
Nothing will bring Hero back, but there is something you can do. A poor relation of mine is anxious for his daughter to marry a nobleman. She is a lovely girl, very like my dear dear daughter. Will you take her as your wife?
Claudia, too close to tears to speak, simply had no choice but to accept. Next scene happens at the chapel. Hero emerges with a veil and Claudia thinks loudly.
Can this be the same Hero that was dead?
She was only there for as long as her innocence was in doubt, my lord.
Claudia's eyes glowed with love and wonder.
Take better care of her this time, Claudio, or I'll have to challenge you again. Is there room for another couple in the chapel? I asked Beatrice to marry me last night and she amazed me by saying yes.
This is how the play ends. The two couples have a double wedding and live happily ever after. Everyone is over the moon except Don John and Borachia, who are now in jail.